Langston and Marco still here?
No, they left a while ago.
Oh, yeah? How'd they look?
Nervous, but happy.
Wish I could say the same about us.
I know a guy that could hook you up with lots of nice pigs but that.
What?
It's pretty obvious those two are on your hit list. It's never too late to do something about it.
I'm way ahead of you.
Wait, dare to dreams?
Who came up with that cheesy theme? It
doesn't even make sense. Once you get REM sleep, your brain makes you dream.
So you were paying attention at bio.
I'm the dumbest kid in class could tell you. You don't dare to dream. What takes daring is trying to make your dream come true.
Well, then you better be a daredevil tonight, because I'm tired of just dreaming of making love to you.
This is like deja vu, only without the big hair sequins and shoulder pads.
You can go now.
Not before I get to dance.
You're kidding me, right?
I thought we had a deal.
Excuse me, can someone tell me how I get backstage?
You're a pussycat doll.
Hi, I'm Nicole. What's your name?
Matthew.
Matthew. Well, it's nice to meet you, Matthew. Wow, who's the lucky girl that gets to be your date tonight?
What?
Is that any way to speak to this hotness?
You mean hot mess.
Oh, is that what you've been cleaning up in here, Mr. Glorified Manny?
I am working. What do you want?
Our brother's phone number.
God, you are hard-headed. What part of no don't you understand?
Then I'll settle for the limo and a ride to the prom. I've got an entrance to make.
Do you know if Ultraviolet's open to the public after the bachelorette party tonight?
No, Jessica booked it.
Gotta make a dumpster run. The stuff went bad. When I get back, I'll tell these stragglers it's last call.
Not so fast.
That stuff's rough.
No, it doesn't mean it can't serve a good cause.
What are you, a geezer? The night's still young.
We are in a wedding tomorrow. You want to go out now?
You want to stay here and watch these lovebirds?
Here's your burger, sis. You must be starving after shaking your assets for everybody.
You know what? I lost my appetite.
Eat. You don't need your energy. I'm taking you out on the town tonight.
Bon appetit.
Well?
What'd I miss? What's going on?
I'm waiting for Nora's answer.
Answer to what?
He proposed to her, but Miss Legalese over here, it looks like she's gonna make him work for it.
I just heard Bo and Michael talking. They are exhuming the baby's body.
What?
It's not gonna take them long to figure out that if it isn't Star's baby in the grave, it's Jessica's.
Then we'll know that Chloe's really Star's baby. Oh my God, how much time do we have?
How long does it take to do a DNA test?
So the reason the center gave me a pass is because I told them...
Did Bo call you?
No. What, did something happen?
I talked to Marcy a little while ago. Hope is being exhumed tonight. We're finally gonna get our answers.
Yourself another chauffeur, because I'm on the clock.
You're answering the door. I'm sure your rich clients can get off their butts for an hour while you take me to prom.
Doesn't your date have a ride?
Tyrone drives a hybrid.
You're going to the prom with Tyrone.
What's wrong with that?
Hey, Sean. How's it going?
Tyrone is your cousin.
Nobody has to know that.
Don't you work nights?
Not tonight.
He took the night off to be my date. That's what family does. They make sacrifices for each other. Now, are you down or not?
Actually, I don't have a date.
What, a good-looking guy like you? What, are the girls at this school blind or just stupid?
Or maybe he's just keeping his options open?
Exactly. My brother's a little heartbreaker.
I can tell.
I'm Rachel, big fan.
Aw, thank you. Oh, well, I guess I better go find the girls.
I think you want to go that way.
Great. Well, it was nice to meet you both. And Matthew, date or no date, actually, I'm going to be your date tonight, so I better see you rocking out there, all right?
Cool.
All right, I'll see you guys later. Bye.
That was awesome.
I told you would have a good time, didn't I? We haven't even been here 5 minutes, and you've already met Nicole from the Pussycat Dolls. Why don't you brag about that to those friends of yours?
What friends?
Those two. Didn't they visit you at the house the other day? What is the big deal?
If you want our sex life to turn into prom gossip, fine by me.
Oh, who cares what people say? You're graduating in a month, and everybody already thinks we've been doing it for 2 years.
They don't know what we've been doing.
Newsflash, nobody thinks we're still virgins. If anything, us not doing it would be the scandal.
I just want tonight to be special and to keep your rep intact.
My rep? I'm considered the biggest freak in the junior class. Gossip about Operation Deflower, if it gets out, is not going to change that. The only person I was worried about finding out was Dorian, and Lola took care of that, so we're in the clear. Think again, prima. From where I'm standing, all kinds of things could go wrong. Really? Like you winding up with a friendly neighborhood drug dealer? Or you winding up pregnant?
Cole, what's wrong?
I mean, I started this whole thing. I just thought I'd have more time to get used to the idea.
I did too when Marcy first told me. I freaked out, but I just want this all to be over with.
There really are people digging our daughter out of the ground right now?
Michael McBain's overseeing all of it.
Then we have to go there.
There's gotta be some way that we can keep this secret.
How? Short of derailing the exhumation.
That's it. That's it. We'll go to Uncle Bo and we'll convince him to stop it. We'll just tell him what a disaster it'd be to dig the baby up.
This is Star and Cole's baby, Natalie, as far as everybody else is concerned. We have no rights. And if we start to make a fuss, we're gonna draw attention that we don't want.
But we have to do something.
Look, there's only one story that will even make your Uncle Bo think twice about considering to exhume Hope's body. The truth.
Okay. Okay, then we'll tell Uncle Bo the truth, okay? Because he's family, and he'll understand more than anyone. Well, we can't tell Jessica, we just...
Stop, Natalie. Stop. There is no way your Uncle Bo will even consider carrying on this lie. Not even for Jessica.
The truth will kill her, Jared.
Look, we will be there for her. Your mom will be there for her, your dad, the rest of the family.
You're saying that there's absolutely no way we can keep this from coming out, aren't you? That her baby's dead.
Why don't we give them some time alone, okay?
Regina ran us some report.
How's the hair? Okay, I understand you're looking for investment.
How long are you gonna keep me hanging here?
Can you wait until I get my drink?
You can't give me an answer without a double shot of liquid courage.
All right, no, wait just a minute here. You come barreling in here in the middle of a bachelorette party for your own daughter. And let me just say this. Supposed to be Natalie's special day, and you take it upon yourself to go in front of a room full of people and to practically demand that I marry you. I feel like I'm negotiating my surrender, so what do you expect me to do?
I expected you to say what took you so long and then give me a hard time, and then I expected you to say, yeah, I'll marry you.
Well, I can give you 2 out of the 3.
You're turning me down?
I'll pull the car around.
Thanks for the hospitality, sis.
We're closing. Get out.
Oh,
Well, Rex and I are going out dancing tonight. And then tomorrow we're going to watch two people be joined in front of that god you're so caught up with. Who knows, maybe Rex and I will get caught up too. Imagining ourselves walking that slow walk down the aisle. Together, just us. Toodles!
How is it possible you're related to her?
I didn't say no.
You didn't say yes, so what are you saying?
I feel like your proposal is just a tad disingenuous.
You think I don't want to marry you?
Not really, no.
Hey, what are you doing?
Party's over and I'm closing up. I'll have the place to myself.
Really?
Yeah, you want to come by when you're done?
Be there in 10 minutes.
Is Jared's party over already?
We got some news that pretty much cleared the whole place out.
What kind of news?
Okay. I gotta come up with a plan or something.
Okay, sweetheart, calm down.
No. I can't. Okay, this isn't just about Jess. Okay, this is about you and me and Mom and Dad. We got all of our lives back together this last year after what happened last year. And now I'm supposed to be the one who's going to blow all of our lives up again? I mean, how am I supposed to do that? How?
After everything Star's been through, to have to go through such a ghastly process?
The exhumation.
You know about it?
Marcy told me about it tonight.
Oh, honey.
I feel so bad for her and Cole and Star.
Oh.
I can't imagine how miserable those kids must feel to exhume that baby, just have to turn around and put her back in the ground.
Well, they're going to feel like they're losing her all over again.
Baby. Why aren't you crying?
You okay? Can you just tell Natalie that I left? I'm fine.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, honey.
Oh, it's official. You are stalking me and Marco.
I'm just trying to have a good time.
Great, then stay away from us.
Fine. I'm just saying that the first time is never all it's cracked up to be.
Oh, you know that from experience?
Call my date a slut?
Look, I'm just saying you're both virgins, so you might be better off with people who are more experienced.
I can't believe you came to prom with this drunk demon piece of crap.
Yeah, do I know you?
Well, Star Manning knows you. She wanted me to give you a message.
Oh!
She said drop dead.
Evening, Matt. How's it going? You're Matt's sister, right? Justin.
Rachel, hi.
And this is Becca.
Hey.
Hi. I'm gonna go inside. Let me know when you need a ride, okay?
Your date's your sister, and even she's ditching you. Can you get any more pathetic?
So, where is everyone?
They're out, except for Aunt Doran, who's probably somewhere wearing out the carpets or marble or whatever.
Does she know about Marco and Langston's after prom plans?
Wait a second.
Marco told me.
Was he bragging to you or something? That's so...
Was Langston bragging when she told you?
No. Girls are very different.
Oh, really?
Yes, really.
So they don't get nervous and excited and turn to you and ask you to buy them condoms when they're too embarrassed to do it themselves?
Margo asked you to buy condoms for him.
Yeah, you can't tell anyone.
Okay, only if you promise not to tell anyone that Aunt Doran gave Langston... a French condom holder.
A French what?
And it was filled.
Phil, that's going on my Christmas list.
No, it's not. This girl.
Oh, man, I want to give him a hard time about that one.
What if we just, like, showed up at prom to give them a hard time?
You know, we could go.
No, we couldn't. I don't have anything to wear. It's a prom.
Okay, you have, like, a million dresses upstairs.
And what would you wear? One of Moe's tuxes?
Actually, I sort of have a tuxedo in my car. Before you told me what was happening with Hope, I was going to ask you if you
wanted to go with me. So do you?
Oh, you are so hot when you're like this.
All right, I gotcha.
Ow.
Save the ow for later. Speaking of which, we're all set, right? Mission accomplished. You got the condoms?
All I try to do is make these kids happy. Can I get any love?
I ask myself that every day.
You want some?
What is it?
It's called DB.
What does it do?
Makes you feel good.
Okay, I'll bite. What school do you go to?
Landview U.
Landview Union Academy. It's a magnet school.
Never heard of it.
They're, really good at
basketball. They win the citywide tournament every year. Have fun with your wheelies while everyone else is out there dancing. Come on, Becca. Let's do this. Wait on that.
You want a drink, cuz?
Cuz?
Yeah, sure. The punch. Go ahead. I'll be right here waiting.
It's kind of a weird nickname for your boyfriend to give you.
He's not my boyfriend, okay? He's my cousin.
Mr. Wheels came to the prom.
That little SOB's been ragging on Matthew this whole time.
Justin's a little freak like that.
Excuse me?
Anyway, that's what my sister says.
She's your sister.
You had a shorty with the beauty and the brains? That's my sassy little sister. You a teacher?
A sister, actually.
Well, I figured that.
To the very sensitive, brave, kick-ass kid in the wheelchair. His name's Matthew. Mine's Rachel.
Destiny? Sean.
Do you think I don't mean my proposal?
Well, I don't know. Maybe you do. I've never seen you do this before. I mean, do you usually propose spur of the moment, all apropos of nothing?
Apropos of nothing?
Well, this is a little out of the blue.
What did you want? Notice?
Oh, for Pete's sake.
You know, when a guy proposes, it's usually a surprise. A happy surprise.
Well, it's a surprise, all right, but we haven't been happy. Just a few hours ago, we weren't happy. Do you remember that? Because I'm still kind of in the recovery phase from that, and now you ask me to spend the rest of my life with you, and I'm feeling a little jerked around.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to make you feel that way.
Where's this coming from?
I'm asking you to marry me because I love you and want to spend the rest of my life with you. But in all honesty, it did start with Bo.
Okay, so it's going to take Bo a couple of days to figure out that the baby in the grave isn't Star. Of course, we do have some time.
For what? To delay the inevitable, Turd? I can't keep lying to everyone. As noble as I may think my reasons are, I have to figure out a way to tell Jessica.
You can't be the one to tell her.
Why not?
Look, you said it yourself. Jessica looks fine, but if she's blocked out what happened to our baby, she's only a house of cards, and we have no idea what knowing the truth's gonna do to her.
Okay, fine, then we'll just bring someone else in on it. We have to tell Mom.
What do you have to tell me?
I didn't hear you come in. Here's the thing. That never happened. No one can know I dance. It's an official state secret. I'd have to deny it if anyone ever asked. Battle-hardened SEALs, we're not sensitive. We never say die, and we don't, under pain of death, dance. What's wrong?
Okay, this is you on short notice, huh?
Is it okay?
You look amazing.
Thanks.
Here, it's no corsage.
No, it's perfect. Could you help me with this? Thanks. I'll just put it right here.
Not wearing your locket tonight?
No. I don't think I can.
Not until I know the truth about Hope.
Come on. Let's go.
You want me to run out to the store, grab you something to fill your stomach?
No, I'll be fine. Just give me a couple seconds, and we can go out dancing.
Are you kidding me? You are down for the count. We are staying in.
No, Rex, please, I'll rally. I want to go party with you.
Other nights.
Another night when you're all upset because your ex has been rubbing her new relationship in your face. Come on, I just want to take your mind.
I'm sure we would have had a good time, but it is not your job to keep my spirits up. You know what I mean?
But you let me stay here free of charge. It's the least I can do.
If it makes you feel any better, taking care of you takes my mind off all that other stuff.
Yeah, I spiked my sister's food. I should have hawked in it, too. I got no one to go home to tonight because that witch took Rex and Shane away from me. Vicky told me I should fight for them, and you know what? I am. Shane needs his parents together almost as much as he needs Stacy's stem cells. And I just have a hard time believing that you would work your miracle through my deadbeat sister. But if you are, that's your choice, because I am through rolling over and playing dead for Stacy.
I knew it! This proposal has nothing to do with you and me. It has everything to do with me and Bo.
Hold on. Bo and I got into it at Rhodey's. Accusations were leveled.
What accusations?
I accused Bo of wanting you back.
Oh.
And he said if I was having any problems with Nora, it was my own damn fault.
And you jumped to the conclusion.
And then he said, if you're not married by now, you are never gonna do it.
Okay, so you hopped in the car and you sped down here to propose.
Well, I know how it looks.
Do you? Do you really? Because from where I'm standing, it looks like this whole proposal isn't because you love me or anything quaint like that. It's because you've got something to prove to your brother.
No, that's not it at all. I don't want to prove anything to Bo. I want to prove something to you.
Prove what?
How I feel. How much you mean to me.
And you want me to prove the same to you?
I don't know what the hell you feel. I do know that I love you. Now the question is, do you love me?
We were thinking of eloping.
Oh, you can't do that to me, baby.
You know what? It's over. It's just the pressure was getting to us and...
Okay, listen. As much as I'd like to hold you to that, you guys have to do what is best for you.
That's right. I second that. You don't sacrifice your happiness that you should feel on your day for anyone.
Right. Okay, we're off. We'll see you at home, and we're taking Roxy home.
I'll see you at the church tomorrow, baby.
Where's Jess? Oh, Jessie left just a few minutes ago. I'm sure she went home for the kids. Okay? Good night, darling. Good night, Jared.
Yeah,
thanks. Come on, Roxy.
Okay.
Okay, I'm sorry I blindsided you, but I didn't know what else to do. Roxy right there, it was not the time or the place to tell your mom.
No, it's just we're running out of time.
Well, you heard your mom. Jessica's home with the kids. Maybe we give her one last happy night with Bree and Chloe, and then we put an end to this tomorrow.
Tomorrow's our wedding day.
So then, tonight, let's put an end to that.
Tyrone's probably waiting for you.
So what? Let him wait. I'm talking to you.
So you're not pissed at me?
Sure I am. I'm at the prom with my cousin because my friend didn't ask me when he should have. But if I didn't speak to people I was mad at, I'd be mute. So, can you dance in that thing?
Only one way to find out.
That's right. We'll hang on to him until you get here.
Libra. Sticky stuff. What?
Dude, I don't do that stuff. Get away from me.
Wait your turn, yo.
I don't think so. You've done selling drugs.
Says who?
Says me. This is the first time I've been back since the accident. I feel like everyone's watching me.
Okay. How about instead of watching them, you look at me and I'll look out for you?
Okay. Want to dance?
Yeah, I'd love to.
Okay. Whatever it is, you can tell me.
My cousin Star's baby, the one that died, they're exhuming it.
Why?
They got the cause of death wrong.
That's a nightmare. You guys close?
Yeah, definitely. Star's great, but it's not that.
What is it that's freaking you out?
Whenever I think about her baby and the moments of life that she had, it's like a punch in the stomach and I can't breathe.
Like an anxiety attack.
I don't know. I don't know what it is. Natalie and Jared are getting married tomorrow. I'm Natalie's matron of honor. I mean, I'm sure I'm gonna get there for people wondering what's going on with me. Am I really sane? You know, is it really water under the bridge that, my altar tried to kill the bride and groom?
In other words, you're going to be the life of the party.
I really wish that you could be there, you know? I'd pull you on the dance floor and just block everything else out.
It won't always be like this. I promise. We'll have that dance one day. Until then, would you settle for a preview?
What do you mean?
Was you have your bridesmaids dressed, yeah?
I had my last fitting today. The garment bag's in the car.
Go get it.
Of course I love you. I'm just finding it a little hard to like you right about now.
Well, I can't blame you, because... And by lately, I mean about the past year. Mm-hmm. I've been a very unlikable fella.
Stubborn.
I was going to get there. Okay. Stubborn, yes. And I was only thinking of myself, so I was selfish, and Bo was good enough to point that out to me.
Okay.
Well, I'm done.
Oh, God.
Being a jealous fool. And I refuse to throw away our partnership and our friendship, which has grown into love that we've enjoyed for nearly 2 years now. Nora, I want to be there for you. And for Matthew, and for Bo. I'd like to be able to prove myself to you every day for the rest of our lives, and I promise you, it won't be as boring as it sounds. I want all of that. If you'll have me.
You know what? You're right. I mean, tomorrow, truth's gonna come out, and we're gonna have to cancel the wedding anyway, so... We might as well do it tonight.
And by this time tomorrow, no one's going to be in any sort of mood to celebrate. So, we may not be getting the wedding that we wanted. But I will be damned if I go to bed one more night without my wife.
To be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Joined together. Let no man put us under.
Prom contest. Well, you wanted them and now you got them. Give it